tell me what you saw and heard, and did it change your mind, or did it cause you even greater concern?
Caused me to wonder about my sanity.
Because it seems insurmountable.
It's not that it's insurmountable. Americans never quit. We've surmounted other things. We'll survive whatever happens. I believe in our strength, and I also believe that if we focus our resources and bring them together, we can be much more effective. But the situation on the ground is serious in both countries. The additional 17,000 troops approved by the president a few days ago are absolutely necessary to stop the deterioration, and we'll move on from there. Some people said you should have waited for the end of the strategic review to send the troops. That option was not available given the situation that President Obama inherited on day one of his presidency. It was a very bad can of worms, and it needed a little injection, if you'll pardon the mixed metaphors. What we have to do next is to finish the strategic review, clarify to the world, to the nation, and to ourselves what we're doing in this part of the world. A lot of people ask questions. There are obvious answers, which we can discuss in a minute, but we want to make it clear in an integrated form, and then marshal our resources and that of other countries for a combined political counterinsurgency, diplomatic, international effort, which has to involve, on the international front, all of Afghanistan's neighbors. And when I say all, I use that word very deliberately. That would include China, which has a common border with Afghanistan of about 90 miles, but it's important to them. India, which is a near neighbor. Pakistan, Russia, a near neighbor with a long and unfortunate history. Pakistan, obviously. Farther afield, Saudi Arabia, Turkey, and our NATO allies are involved. And there's one other country on the west.
Iran.
Oh, very good. You know, after 20 years of doing this show, often with me, you're really on top of this today, Charlie.
Join us online at charlierose.com.